Welcome to GripeCast with your host, Alex Hernandez. This show is dedicated to consumer technology news and pop culture. GripeCast is owned by Techaeris. Visit Techaeris.com for the latest tech reviews, news, entertainment, and pop culture. Now sit tight, the show is about to begin. All right, welcome to the least listened to podcast on the internet. This is GripeCast, episode 10. I am currently on vacation, hence the change in scenery behind me. I attempted to record this podcast earlier, but was met with some, let's say, natural challenges. Yeah, I wanted to kind of give you guys a different perspective, a different view, so I recorded outside. Thought I had things set up properly, but the audio was really not good, and there was a lot of wind, so I decided to scrap that podcast and re-record, and just come inside and do this here. So apologies for not having a nice background here, if you're watching on YouTube, or Rumble, or MeWe. But I thought, you know, I think the audio is more important than the visual. And this way, you at least have my my screen if you're watching. But more importantly, the audio is going to be better, much, much better than what I started with. So yeah, I'm on vacation, guys. I am on vacation. I'm going to make this podcast a short one. I'm going to try to anyway. I've been trying to enjoy myself, trying to get through vacation time, spending time with my wife and kids. And just enjoying ourselves down here in Alabama, and just enjoying the warm, muggy weather that we're having right now. Getting in the ocean a little bit, and pool, and doing all the things you do on vacation. So, yep. You know, I've been trying to stay disconnected from the internet, and trying to just enjoy vacation. I mean, that's what I need to do. But, you know, as most of you know, we are still wrestling with Google, still trying to get through that whole situation, and that is what I've been kind of keeping track of. But there are other things that are happening in the world of tech and tech and in general. I mean, there's a lot of things happening all over the place. I wanted to talk about the Apple iPad Pro launch. You know, I usually cover all of Apple's events, but I wasn't that interested in the iPad Pro, mostly because I didn't think that they would bring anything new or exciting. It's been the last couple of years that they've promised, the last couple iterations of the iPad Pro, that they're always promising that it's going to be the next desktop replacement or laptop replacement. And just, you know, I have a 12.9 iPad Pro, which I'm using right here. I keep looking to my right over here because I have OBS on this side over here so I can see what I'm doing. And then I have you guys right here on my screen to look at my desktop, my laptop. But I have an iPad Pro 12.9, it's 2021, and I like it. It's a nice tablet, but I've tried to use it as a laptop replacement, but the screen's too small, and it lacks some of the things that a laptop has that this does not, that I need. You know, for some people, maybe it does. Maybe it's a laptop replacement. But as I suspected, this new iPad Pro isn't going to fulfill what I need in a laptop. It's still too small, even a 13-inch. It's powerful. It's got an M4 chip. You know, it's got all the goodies like that. So, without a doubt, they've increased the power and capabilities. It's just still not. I think iPad OS is what's holding it back. I think that the iPad OS needs to become a little bit more like Mac OS in order for it to be a successful laptop replacement. The power is there, but the utility, I don't think, is quite there, at least for some people, for me, for sure. Some other people, you know, it may be a perfect desktop replacement. But for me, it's not. But that all aside, that's not even the big story when it comes to iPad Pro. The big story is the commercial that they came out with. I'm going to play it here in a second. If you're not familiar with it, but I think most people are, the commercial shows a bunch of items being crushed in a press. Items like trumpet, trombone, musical instruments, guitars, retro gaming consoles, monitors, computers, paints, artwork, books, all sorts of stuff, record players. All these things are being compressed, and you see them get crushed, and then you see the iPad Pro, at the end of it. And what Apple is trying to say is, look at all the things that we can do in this thin little device, the iPad Pro, and you can have all of this in this small footprint. And I get where they're going with it. I understand the marketing behind it, and I understand the commercial, but I know it ticked off a lot of people. And I think people were upset because they felt that Apple was discounting the importance of a lot of these items that we've lived with and that we still use. I mean, guitars. I mean, I play guitar all the time. iPad Pro is not going to replace a guitar for me. Paintings, people paint, they create. You can't replace that with an iPad Pro. Yeah, you can use an Apple Pencil, and some people do that, and people make great art with an Apple Pencil and iPad Pro, but the iPad Pro has not replaced a lot of these things, and that is what the message was. And then someone came out and reversed the commercial. They did it in reverse, and they said that Apple should have done this, and they created the commercial so the items, instead of being compressed, they were being uncompressed, as if, you know, the other messages for that, to go that route, is to say, look at all the things that can be inside of this iPad Pro. And some were saying, you know, that's a better way to have done that. You know, I'm kind of indifferent with the whole thing. I didn't like the commercial. It wasn't the greatest Apple commercial I've ever seen. It didn't really offend me that much. I mean, yeah, to see some things crushed, if it was real, which I don't think it was, but maybe it was real. I can understand people's perspective in that. So I get it. But I'm going to play it real quick and see. And I'm going to try not to talk over it. There's really no talking on it. It's mostly just a little bit of a backing song, a backtrack song, and then just everything getting crushed. I'm going to keep the volume low. Last podcast I did, when I played video through the podcast, it was a little loud and you couldn't hear me talking. I'm going to maybe try talk a little bit, but let's just watch this commercial and see what this commercial was all about. And you see pianos and retro game paints, artwork, metronome, sculptures, Angry Birds, cameras and camera lenses, and oh, the guitar. And emojis. And the compressor comes up, and there you have your iPad Pro. It's also the thinnest. So that's it. That's the commercial everybody's up in arms about. I'm the type of guy that can see the perspective of both sides. Like, I see Apple's aim or goal with this commercial, but obviously it didn't land well with some users. So what do you think? I mean, what do you think about it? Comment in whatever platform you're listening on, and just let us know. Let me know what you think. All right. Let's move on. I'm really only talk about three things today, and that was iPad Pro. We're going to talk about AdVon, and we're going to talk about Google again. I'm sorry. I know you guys are probably sick and tired of me talking about Google, but it's been the thing for the past 3-4 months, at least for me. And AdVon. Now, we've talked about this. We've talked about this situation where, oh, man, big publishers have been using AI to write their articles. And Sports Illustrated actually got caught doing this. They had fake writers and they had fake content. Now, what's been coming out lately is a lot of these big publishers have been using AI content to kind of bolster and promote like e-commerce and couponing and that type of side thing on their websites. I mean, if you look at a site like Forbes, even Mashable, and I think even CNET, all have coupon pages on their domains. So a lot of that stuff's been AI written, and it only exists to push traffic and to get traffic for, you know, people looking for coupons, looking for deals, looking for all that stuff. So they make money from that. They partner with coupon companies, and they do all this type of stuff for affiliate linking, and it earns them money. And you know, I don't disparage them for that. I use affiliate links. We've paused our affiliate linking right now because of Google. Google is not looking kindly on affiliate linking. So right now, that is just another revenue stream that's been paused for me. But the big publishers, they've been doing it, and they were using the AI-powered content to do this. I'm going to link all this stuff. It's going to be linked in the show notes. I'm making this podcast as short as possible. I got to get back to vacation, but I wanted to get this on your radar. Futurism writes, "Meet AdVon, the AI-powered content monster infecting the media industry." Remember that AI company behind Sports Illustrated's fake writers? We did some digging, and it's got tendrils into other surprisingly prominent publications. USA Today is one of them. The article is very, very, very long, but you should go read it. The gist of it is AdVon is a company. It's a marketing company, and they supply large publishers and many other industries with AI content. And it's marketing content. So very much ad-driven, affiliate-driven. So that's how they're making money. The company developed a system that they call Mel. And what Mel does is it generates AI content. And then the company has a human kind of quick edit anything. And then it gets posted on the various sites like USA Today. Futurism writes, "We first heard of AdVon last year after staff at Gannett, noticed product reviews getting published on the website of USA Today with bylines that didn't seem to correspond to real people. The articles were stilted and formulaic, leading the writers' union to accuse them of being shoddy AI. When Gannett blamed the strange articles on AdVon, we started digging. We soon found AdVon had been running similar operations at the magazine Sports Illustrated, publishing product reviews using bylines or fake writers with fictional biographies and AI-generated profile pictures. The response was explosive. The magazine union wrote that it was horrified. While its publisher cut ties with AdVon and subsequently fired its CEO before losing the rights to Sports Illustrated entirely." So, that's what these publishers are doing right now. And Futurism goes on, and this is going to tie into my Google talk in here in the next segment. Futurism says, what we found should alarm anyone who cares about a trustworthy and ethical media industry. Basically, AdVon engages in what Google calls site reputation abuse. It strikes deals with publishers in which it provides huge numbers of extremely low-quality product reviews, often for surprisingly prominent publications, intended to pull in traffic from people searching things on Google, like Best Ab Roller. The idea seems to be that these visitors will be fooled into thinking the recommendations were made by the publication's actual journalists and click one of the article's affiliate links, kicking back a little money if they make a purchase. Exactly what I said. The article is very long. Go read it. This is what these companies are doing. They are using AdVon to generate these fake reviews. You know, we do our reviews. We get reviews. We get review units. We're up front with that. You know, we get units from Samsung and from Dell and from Lenovo and from Acer and from a variety of different companies, brands. They send us review units all the time. You know, 80% of the stuff has to go back. TVs go back. Everything goes back to the brand. We don't keep. Occasionally we'll keep headphones or something like that that they don't want back. Consumables. You know, nobody wants. You know, you stick a pair of earbuds in my ear. The company doesn't want that back. It's gross. And kind of the same thing with headphones. You know, you get sweaty and stuff. They're not going to want those back. But at any rate, we do our actual reviews, and AdVon is not doing this. And they are using. Well, excuse me. I don't want to blame AdVon completely. We have to take into account the brands, the journalists, or the media brands like USA Today that are doing these things. And they've just been caught red-handed. So I just wanted to bring this to your attention. I wanted to put it on your radar so you guys can go read this article and see exactly what we're up against. Our legitimate independent reviews are just being drowned out by these AI garbage reviews where nobody's touched the equipment. It's absolute nonsense, just fake. So make sure you click the link below, check the show notes, and read that for yourself. I'm just going to jump into Google. A lot to talk about Google. I mean, I didn't even know where to start with Google. Again, that site reputation abuse, talking about the AdVon, site reputation abuse, that policy, thankfully, I've looked at my manual action. So if you get a manual action from Google, that's the site reputation abuse policy is going to come as a manual action. And thankfully, I haven't had that. I've been checking every day for the past few days. We have not been hit with site reputation abuse, thank God. But a lot of these companies are, a lot of these websites are being hit with site reputation abuse. But they were, you know, let's take USA Today or Forbes. They were warned by Google ahead of time and told what they were going to do. Now, the site reputation abuse is not being implemented the same way that the HCU or the reviews update or the March core update. All the other updates that Google has done have been aimed at independent publishers, and all of the updates affected the core domains. So it wasn't single pages, it wasn't single categories, it wasn't any of that. It was explicitly the entire domain. So our entire domain was affected, even if it's only one page that was bad. With the site reputation abuse now, they're doing different. And I think it's because, and this is my opinion, I think it's because the majority of the abusers are big brands like USA Today and Forbes. These brands are site reputation abusers, and Google is allowing them to only take a penalty on those pages that were being manipulated. So the entire domain is not being punished. that, I'm sorry, is BS. Because we've done none of this, and our entire domain's been affected. Just like other independent sites. All the entire domain. Just obliterated. But Google is playing nice with the big brands. So, Cyrus SEO on X says, Google is severely reducing monetization incentives for publishers because they can't deal with scaled AI low-quality content. By doing so, they will inevitably throw out high-quality content. That's a price they are willing to pay. It's not coming out of their pocket. So that is what they're doing with our other updates, not the site reputation, but the core update and the HCU, the helpful content update, and the reviews update. There's been a lot of updates since September of last year. So what Cyrus SEO is saying is Google is punishing not only sites that are severely bad, but really good sites, independent sites, and they don't care. They're throwing out, they're casting a wide net, and whatever they catch, they're throwing it out, whether it's good or bad. They don't care. So, that's where we're at. Let's see here. Carl Hendy has a really long but good post talking about Vouchergeddon. And again, that's Vouchergeddon. He's talking about coupon sites. Again, that's the site reputation abuse. Man, you know, there's so much happening right now with Google. And if I want you guys to comment, let me know if you guys are seeing weird results in Google's search results. Like here, somebody did a search on how to get rid of cockroaches. And this is what Google's AI returned. Coat them in oil. Eat them. Shoot them with a missile. Pour acid on them. Microwave them. Put them in a pill bottle and shake violently for 5 minutes. Coat them in oil. I mean, this is helpful content to Google? What the heck is this? It's just ridiculous what is happening. And it's just getting worse. I'm sorry. It's just getting worse day by day. I have a couple things bookmarked here. Sundar Pichai talks about the state of search and new content and AI, and he's full of crap. It's just so much. I'm going to link several things down in the show notes. Again, I didn't want to make this podcast too long. I'm here on vacation. I'm on vacation. I just wanted to touch base with everybody. Just remind you that I'm still in the game, guys. I'm not going anywhere right now. I have to pivot. I have to change the way I do things, and we're working on that. So hopefully we'll get through this. I just want you guys to continue to be aware of what Google's doing. Continue to be aware of how you can help us. Right now, my advice is stop using Google. Bookmark Techaeris. Bookmark the sites that are independent. Bookmark the sites that you trust. Use independent sites more often. Don't depend on mainstream sites. Don't think you're getting good information from any of those sites. And, you know, I think that I know that some people will argue that Reddit is a good source, and I don't dispute that there's some good information on Reddit. I think you can find good information. I think there's some users there that are helpful. But don't discount independent sites. Don't discount us as experts as well, because we are. A lot of us have been doing this for a long time, and we've been down in the dirt, and we've been clawing, and we've been doing this thing. So I just think that you need to curate your own news feed, curate your own information. Stop relying on search to do that for you. Don't rely on Google to do that for you anymore. AI is just going to spit out garbage at you, and it's going to start spitting out stuff that makes no sense. It's nonsensical. So I don't know where we're going, man. I don't know what's happening. I don't know where anything's going to land right now in this landscape. But we're hoping and praying that we're going to land in a good position. Even though right now it just seems like we're down in a deep crevasse of doubt. And it's dark, but we're looking at the light, and hopefully we can get through this. I am going to head back on vacation, guys. I'm going to go have some dinner, have a few shrimp, spend some time with my family, watch The Hobbit, and we're just going to relax for the rest of the day. I hope you guys have been well. Hope you guys have a great rest of the week. Have a great weekend. Take care of yourselves. Be blessed. And we will talk to you on the other side.